The Soybean School on RealAgriculture.com is brought to you by Pride Seeds, Nodulator Pro, and Cruiser Max Vibrance Beans.
Well, good morning. It's wonderful to be here on the first day of summer looking at soybeans. And one of the issues, of course, that we've had this year are poor plant stands. If you go into Lambton County, there's some really tough fields, and you know, producers even just yesterday and this week still replanting. And a lot of us, we're up here at the Perth Demo Farm today, north of Mitchell. Things look pretty good, although they're starting to dry up. But here we've got a nice little comparison for us. We're doing some rolling trials here, but one of the things we're also doing is just some pre-tillage, one pass with an RTS type of unit versus straight no-till. And one of the issues, of course, that we constantly get into with no-till is getting enough plants per acre. And you can see right here, this side was straight no-till, and if I put my hula hoop down here on my hoop, I have marked the number of plants I need for different plant stands. So 16 in this hoop is about 100,000. And what I'm looking for is 24 plants. 24 plants is 150,000 per acre in my hoop, and that's 100% yield potential. 100,000, still okay, probably in the range of only losing a 2-3 bushels, 4 on the outside in this environment. So let's take a look here, and you can see even visually the pre-till beans a little more vigorous, a little more green. Does that matter in the end? Well, let's talk about that. Okay, first we're gonna do a quick plant stand count here, and if I kneel down and take a quick look, I get about 21 in there, and so 20 would be 125,000. You know what? I'm happy with that. Is it where I want to be? No, it's not. But for no-till, first day of summer, certainly nothing we're going to do about that. Now, let's look over here, pre-tillage, and we'll do another quick count here. So I get about 26 plants there, and like I said before, that's 24 would be 150,000. So this would be, in my estimation, from the previous work that we've done, 100% yield potential. And you know, part of the issue with no-till is not so much the fact that they are paler right now, a little bit shorter, but often it's simply an issue of not having enough plants per acre because we lose some. So, you know, how can we get around that? Well, personally, I have found that this pre-tillage is a good way to try and get us a few more plants per acre, a little more vigorous growth. Now, at the end of the day, fair bit of work has been done on this. Yield advantage to this over this, on average, 2 bushels, right? Now, having said that, I think in this scenario, with it being this stark right here, probably closer to 3 or more bushels, right? Now, let's talk for a second about seeding depth. One of the issues, of course, this year was it was getting so dry that we were looking for moisture, right? And you have to plant soybeans, we say about 1 centimeter roughly into moisture. Kind of a normal seeding depth would be 1.5 inches, right? And of course, this year, how deep do you go? How deep can you go if it's really dry? And generally, we say that 2.5 inches on our gauge is about the maximum for most soybean. Now, that doesn't sound like a lot until you look at a soybean seed and you compare it to that 2.5 inches, and you think about the fact that it needs all its energy from that those little cotyledons to make it out of that ground 2.5 inches. It's actually incredible that the bean can do it. Now, if anything goes wrong, and it did for a lot of us this year, a little bit of crusting, or there's a little bit of seed coat crack on these seeds, or a little bit of feeding, whatever, all of a sudden the bean can't make it out. So when we say 2.5 inches as a maximum, that really is pushing it to the utmost degree. And generally, you know, that 1.5 is lots. And you know what? If there's moisture early in the season, maybe no-till, because there's less drying out, I'm okay with even going an inch. And we had some pretty good success with just shallower seeding depth. Now, one final thought on that. There's no evidence in the soybean world that we need to go a certain depth for root structure or those kind of things, unlike corn, where of course we know we need to get corn into the ground. Beans, we don't have that in our environment. The whole trick is to get them out of the ground.